Coach, if you would, please make an opening statement.
First of all, South Carolina is an amazing basketball team and coached by an unbelievable coach. I just thought they came out really attacking this win and attacking the NCAA tournament the right way. And honestly, I thought our team did too. I thought that the scrap and the effort, no matter what the score was, I'm just so proud of this team. And I love them as basketball players, but I love them so much more as human beings and the way that they carry themselves. The community of PC and a lot of the basketball community has just fallen in love with this team because of who they are, how happy we are. We enjoy being around each other. We just absolutely, the last 2 weeks have been just an absolute blast and some of my most favorite moments as a coach. And I've done this for 18 years now. And just where we were in the early stages of January to where we are now, and we've just played really, really good basketball at the right time. And it just goes back to character and culture wins. And that is why they stuck together and did not quit on me, and I'm just so thankful to be their head coach.
Open up for questions for just the student athletes at this time. If you would raise your hand, we'll get a microphone to you. We'll start in the third row there.
Hi, both of you guys. What kind of, it seems like you guys were having to play in fast forward because of whether it was their speed or their length or whatever. Just what kind of problems did they present for you guys, especially defensively and on the boards?
Brianna, you want to take that first?
They're a very physical team, and they're strong. I think that definitely affected just us playing. They pushed the ball. We had to try to slow ourselves down because we kept finding ourselves getting sped up by their offense and like their transition and whatnot. I mean, they're a good team. It is what it is. We play hard. We go out there and we try to dictate things and box out and do the things that we can control. And I think that is an area that we definitely grew from the first time.
Yeah.
Tilda?
Yeah, I mean, we all know they are incredible team. They have such a lot of talent in their team. I mean, they are undefeated this season. Every team has struggled with their talent and their basketball. But, I mean, yeah, we were fighting. And, yeah, they are a good team. But I thought we did better than last time. But, yeah, they're a good team.
Other questions for the student athletes? Let's go to Chapel here, and then we'll go to...
Hey, for both players, basketball side, Coach mentioned yesterday that Dawn Staley stopped by the team hotel, I think, Tuesday night. How did that kind of come about, and what was it like to meet someone who just, you know, means so much to the women's game in general?
Tilda, you want to take that first?
Yes. No, it was so cool. I mean, she's such a good coach, and she's changing the women basketball. And like we have said before, like, the women basketball are just growing, and she's definitely one of them who makes the women basketball grow. And it was very cool seeing someone and talk to someone, asking questions to someone that has changed basketball. And I mean, we all look up to her and that team that she's coaching. So it's such a cool experience talking to her, seeing her, and also now get to play with them or against them.
I agree. When she first, when we were trying to figure out like who was coming, we knew it was a surprise, but we didn't know what was gonna come through that door. And when she did, we all kind of were starstruck. And she was like, "Hi, guys," and we were like, and we were still stuck. And she said, "Hi," like, and then we kind of broke that barrier that we were stuck in. But it was so cool just being able to talk to her and let her and hear what she had to say to us and congratulating us and stuff like that. From somebody as great as she is, it means so much. It was good to be able to pick her brain a little bit and see what she had to say, how she was feeling, and just anything. We took anything, we soaked it all in. Everyone says enjoy the moment, enjoy the process, and that was definitely a very cool experience to be able to meet one of the greats. I appreciate her taking her time to come out there, and it was really cool for me. I mean, you look up to people like her. As you go through this process as well, we're all in the basketball world, in the women's basketball world, and it's really exciting to meet somebody who's doing such great things in that side.
Todd?
Tilly, Coach mentioned how happy you guys always are. And this might be a weird question coming after a 50-point loss, but was that fun?
Yeah, I mean, I thought it was fun, and we were hustling and everything. I mean, obviously it's not fun to lose any time, but if we're going to lose, we better do it to the number one seed. And I think small school like us doesn't want to play on the big stage like this. I think I heard someone from the last games being saying, like, at least we don't play South Carolina. But, I mean, I'm so grateful for the experience. And we did what we have worked on, and I love the experience. Playing on the big stage, that's what every athlete want to do. And, I mean, yeah, the score obviously wasn't on our side or anything. They are such a good team, but this is experience that I'm going to bring forever in my basketball, and I'm so grateful that I got to play these two times. And on the when in the NCAA tournament, it's been a journey, and finishing like this, I mean, we want to be sent home against the number one seed, and I'm happy we did. I'm cheering for South Carolina this tournament, so yeah.
Pete.
Yeah, for both of you guys, Coach was talking about how special this season is. You know, when you look back on this season, I mean, you won an NCAA tournament game. What can what you've accomplished do for the program going forward, do for the campus, do for everything that's involved with Presbyterian College?
Tilda, you want to go first?
Yeah, I mean, we have just such a journey, and I mean, we got to remember this season for not the last game, but the whole season, especially the last 2 weeks. It's been so cool experience. We just kept on making history, going just to the semifinals in our tournament, a conference tournament, and I'm so happy for this experience. And yeah, like I said, we need to remember this season for what we have accomplished and not the last game.
I agree. We definitely put PC out there and brought a name to the things that we've accomplished, making history not once, not twice, but three different times, four different times. I think that it says a lot about just our character, too, and we believe in each other. We go out there and we do what we're supposed to do. We had the mentality of going out there and doing what we were supposed to do, what got us here, and then showing our growth. As for PC and the school and whatnot, I think it just brings the community closer together. People took the time to come out and watch us and come down the road and greet us when we came home the first time and all of these things. Like, we're just making the community so much stronger, and I'm really, really glad to be a part of it. It means a lot.
Let's go to the third row there.
Bree, you came out late in the game and you had one last chance to, you know, get a hug and hear everybody cheer for you over on that sideline. What was that like?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It's different for me this time around because I've been through it once before. And last year when I thought my career was over, I went through those emotions and all of that and thinking that it was done, thinking it was over. So when the time came again and Coach Sharp gave me a hug, it's like, making me realize it's over, but it's okay. You know what I mean? Like, hearing everybody around, like, I came back for a sixth year to do great things. I accomplished my goal, and I wouldn't have rather do it with anybody but these girls, these coaches, and everybody around me. It felt good to hear everybody cheering, and of course those emotions come through because it's my last career game, but regardless of that, I wouldn't have wanted to end it any other way.
Let's go to the second row there.
Tilly, was this the most packed or loudest game you've ever played in, and how did it feel to kind of be on the court with that many fans cheering?
Yeah, I mean, I said it to my teammates in the warm-up, like, that this might be the game that I have the most fans and other people watching us. And, I mean, we have a lot of people cheering for us, and they knew who we're playing against. I'm just so happy they came and watched us still. They know what we have done too, and for them coming up here and watch us and support us, that means a lot. And, I mean, playing on the big stage, that's so fun to me. And, I mean, yeah, I want to do it again.
Any other questions for the student athletes? If not, they can go on back to the locker room. Thank you all.
Thank
Congratulations.
You. Thank you.
We'll take questions now for Coach Sharp. Raise your hand. We'll get a microphone to you. Chapel's got the first one.
Hey, Coach, you talked talked a lot about South Carolina yesterday, how good they are to see them up in person. I guess, what did you learn about why this team is 33-0 and title favorites?
I think there's a lot of reasons why that they are 33-0. You know, the first thing is it's hard to put a game plan together because there's so many pieces and so many weapons. If you help off this person's a really great shooter, and they're bringing scores off the bench. They had two of their best scorers not even suited up today. And the way that they defend and their length, the pace that they play with, there's just so many things that they do so well as a basketball team. And in their last five games, they had been offensive rebounding 44% of their missed shots. And I look at the stat sheet and they do it again today, and they shot it so well. And they didn't miss a lot of shots, but they're a great basketball team. And I think Coach Staley, she's not afraid to coach her kids either. She brings them off the bench. She plays the ones that deserve to start. And I think that that's why their toughness and how hard they play. And I thought Chloe Kitts was a really handful today. She went 9 for 9 from the field. I thought she played really well for them off the bench, and they're just they're a great basketball team. They've got a lot of athletes, and it's hard to help and dig and really team defend because there's always someone else ready to knock a shot down.
Pete.
Laura, I think it was I think Tilda had said that, you know, she thought that you guys played better this time than in December. Did you feel that as well, that was a better game for you guys against them than in December?
Yeah, and I think that we were in a little bit of a better position to be successful, just you know, not playing the night before. I mean, at least we had 2 days before, and we did a walkthrough yesterday to try to get our legs back under us, and I thought we were a little back on our heels. I didn't love the way we started the game, but I love the way that we continue to compete. And I think I told him in a timeout, you know, there's potentially a million people watching us play and all these people in here, and we want to make sure that everybody knows how we fight and how we scrap and what really represent a PC, what represents a PC women's basketball player, because it's why we're here. It's why we survived. It's why we advanced. It's why we won 3 games in a row as the 5 seed in our conference tournament, is because of the toughness and the grit and the resilient spirit of our team.
Let's go over to, go ahead right there, and then we'll work over to Todd and Chapel.
Coach, can you talk about just the roller coaster of the low lows and then, you know, to finish where you are right now?
Yeah, I think there were obviously some low lows, and most seasons are a little bit of an up and down season. Most times you can't get to where you want to get as a straight line. It's always bumpy and rocky, and I think that there's been times where the players have been frustrated with me and I've been frustrated with them, but I just feel like we have these deep-seated human connections with each other, and because of that, we were able to really just stick together, and it's almost like the rockier it got and the more rough it got, the better we got. And the thing about it is, you know, I worked for Joy Lee McNellis, who's the head coach at University of Southern Mississippi, and everybody knows that she's battling cancer. And in our pink game, we did a McNellis strong game. And I FaceTimed her after we won the championship game, because she gave me the chance at the Division I level. I mean, I had applied for a million jobs, and she took a chance on me. And I FaceTimed her, and I told her that ever since we wore those McNellis strong T-shirts, we started playing so much tougher and so much scrappier, and I just love that we were doing it in those T-shirts. But that's what we want our program to be about, is just resilient and family and relationships. And if you notice our team, they high-five, they support each other. Dogne Epsite, you know, she's on the bench. She hardly ever gets into the rotation, and she's one of the greatest humans I've ever coached. Her attitude and how hard she goes every single day, her emotions after the game, knowing that our season was over, she was very emotional. So top to bottom, injured players, coaching staff, I just feel like we do it the right way, you know, just really trying to put culture and character first.
Todd.
Coach, from Wednesday to today, did you notice any change of atmosphere in this building? did it make you appreciate that early game with a home feel even more?
Yeah, and I know that there's a lot of talk about feeling that they want regional sites and stuff for the first few rounds of women's basketball, but I love the environment. I think it's awesome for the game. I even looked up and I bumped the assistant coach, and I was like, or one of our assistant coaches, and I'm like, do you see the people in the upper deck? I don't remember there being people up there the last time that we played. And it's so, I'm so thankful, like Tilda said, to be able to experience this type of atmosphere again. I think it was even a little bit more incredible than the first time that we played here. But it's just what Coach Staley has done with her program. I mean, when she took over, where it was and where it is now and how many people have rallied around her. I mean, that's the goal of all of us as head coaches. I mean, that's what I feel like in a lot smaller scale. We've done that somewhat in the last couple months with our own program, where students have started showing up to our home games. And our you know, I think we were like last in attendance when I took over at Presbyterian, and we've been able to move the needle. And I just hope one day that we can have sellout crowds in our own gym on the smaller scale. But that's the goal, and that's what we're trying to do. And being able to compete in an environment that has done that, it's just awesome, and I'm thankful.
Chapel.
Hey, your players mentioned Dawn dropping by the hotel. I know you talked about that already, but you know that's something she could have said no to. What does it mean for South Carolina to kind of roll out the red carpet, per se, to y'all as the 16 seed outside of the game itself?
Yeah, I mean, we felt the same way, too, at our Big South tournament. I thought our Big South administration did a great job of putting that together. And then we come to the NCAA tournament and the experience that our players have had. I mean, we told them there was a surprise coming, and they were guessing like Barack Obama, since he had picked us in the bracket, J. Cole. So it was really kind of giggling around, just listening to all the people that they were guessing. And I watched the video of their reaction when she walked in, probably 12 times, because I wanted to see each person and how they reacted. I mean, their faces. It just shows what she means to everyone that's either coaching or involved in the women's game. And our players were excited. And I made sure to tell them, you know, she didn't have to come by. She didn't have to do that. But she knows that she has a platform and how people feel about her. And I just think that that shows why she is who she is. She's just a good person, and I appreciate her investing in our program.
Pete.
Laura, we talked about some of the history that you guys have made this year. What can it do? And you talked about wanting to move the needle there on campus. I mean, you still at PC are going to face some limitations in enrollment size and things like that. How can this help, this season help build your program going forward?
Well, it's another step. You know, I think that you lay a foundation for your program, and I think the foundation has been lifted up a little bit of where we'll start going forward and into the future. But I think what happens when you have a group of kids that experience winning and experience what a championship feels like and knows that every time you make it to the next round, there's more surprises in the locker room and just all the fun that comes with winning and competing with some of the best. I mean, we played after North Carolina, Michigan State. I mean, that is awesome and a dream come true for our program. But once those players experience this, then they teach the younger players, this is what we're competing for. This is what we're working for every day. And then it's ingrained in your program. And we have a lot of young players. I love what Tilda said, exactly what she said. We got to clip that. We got to send that out to recruits. She said, I want to be back. I want to come back. And that's the kind of winner that she is. And she's only a sophomore. And you guys saw her. She competed like a senior. She's a winner. And our program is full of those.
Last question.
You talk a lot about growing the women's game and how important that is to you. I think after the first four win, there was a clip of you talking about that that went pretty viral. How does it feel to become such a big part of that?
Well, I hope I'm a part of growing it. I know that's something that I want to do, but focusing in on our own community. I mean, I got a text message today that someone's either second or third grade class watched the game in their class. And when we got back from the Big South Championship, there were like 25 pictures from an elementary school that drew pictures congratulating our team and our players. And so all I want to do is be a role model in our community, and our players want to be role models. We have pen pals that we write back and forth to. So that's something that we've always tried to do and wanted to do. But kind of like I said before, just this team, the way that they carry themselves, there's just – when you're around them, you start experiencing the fun and the joy. And that is why we've kind of lit a fire in the Clinton community. And I'm so glad people finally have realized it. And winning helps, obviously. And I'm just hoping that it springboards the future of the program for people to continue to rally around our women's basketball program in our community specifically.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.